Laudetur Jesus Christus. Welcome to Vatican Media for prayer of the Regina Coeli by His Holiness Pope Francis at St. Peter's Square. I am Deacon Cesar, and I would like to welcome all of you who are joining us through different channels of Vatican Media, and those of you joining us through EWTN TV and Shalom World TV. Today is the fifth Sunday of Easter as we continue to celebrate the resurrection of the Lord. This morning in Rome, we join the Holy Father to hear his message, to pray with him, and to receive his blessing. We can see the crowd in St. Peter's Square, gazing the window of the Holy Father, awaiting for him. Thousands of pilgrims from Italy, and indeed around the world, being embraced by the maternal arms of Mother Church. We have a beautiful day here in Rome, a sunny day. And here is Pope Francis greeting the crowd. Now we hear his message. Dear brothers and sisters, good morning. On this fifth Sunday of Easter, the Word of God continues to show us the way and how to be a community of the risen Lord. Last Sunday, the reading highlighted the relationship between the believer and Jesus the Good Shepherd. Today, the Gospel tells us of the moment in which Jesus presents himself as the true vine and invites us to remain united with him in order to bear much fruit. The vine is a plant that forms a whole with its branches, which are fertile only if they remain one with the vine. This relationship is the secret of Christian life, and the Evangelist John expressed it with the verb to remain, which is repeated seven times in today's passage. One must remain with the Lord in order to find the courage to go out of ourselves, out of our comfort zones, out of our narrow and protected spaces, to go forth into the open sea made up of the needs of others, and thus give example breath to our Christian witness in the world. This courage springs from the faith in the risen Lord and from the certainty that His Spirit accompanies our history. One of the most mature fruits that is born from communion with Christ is, in fact, our commitment to show charity towards our neighbor and to love one's brothers and sisters with self-sacrifice, right down to the ultimate consequences, just as Jesus loved us. The dynamism of our true believer's charity is not a result of strategies. It does not arise from external solicitations, from social or ideological demands, but from the encounter with Jesus and from remaining in Jesus. For us, He is the vine from which we absorb the sap, that is, the life that we bring into society, a different way of living and spending, which puts the last in the first place. When one is intimate with the Lord, just as the vine and the branches are intimate and united with each other, one is able to bear fruit of new life, of mercy, of justice, and of peace, springing from the resurrection of the Lord. This is what the saints did, those who fully lived the Christian life and were witnesses of charity, because they were true branches of the Lord's vine. To be holy does not require being a bishop, a priest, or a religious. We are all called to be holy by living our lives with the Lord, by bearing witness in everything we do, wherever we find ourselves. Every activity, work and rest, family and social life, the exercise of political, cultural and economic responsibilities, every activity, you live in union with Jesus and with an attitude of love and service, is an opportunity to live baptism and evangelical holiness to the full.
Nulla, infatti, possiamo senza di Lui, perché la nostra vita è Cristo vivo, presente nella Chiesa.
We can do nothing without Jesus.
Regina Coeli, letare, alleluia.
Quiaque meruisti portare, alleluia.
Resurrexit, sicut dixit, alleluia.
Ora pro nobis Deum, alleluia.
Gaudet, letare, Virgo Maria, alleluia. Deus, qui per resurrezione fili tui Domini nostri Jesu Christi, mundo natificare dignatus est, presta quesumus, ut per eius genitricem Virgen Maria, perpetue capiamus gaudia vite, per unde in Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine,
et lux perpetua lucet eis,
requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen. Amen.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, ieri a Cracovia è stata
proclamata. Dear brothers and sisters,
Anna Sianowska,
yesterday in Krakow, He was proclaimed blessed. Anna Krasowska.
Rendiamo grazie a Dio per la testimonianza di questa.
She was a lay faithful who dedicated her life to caring for the sick, in whom she saw the face of the suffering Jesus. Let us give thanks to God for the witness of this apostle of the sick and strive to imitate her example.
Per una penisola coreana libera dalle armi nucleari.
I accompany with my prayers the positive outcome of last Friday's inter-Korean summit and the courageous commitment made by the leaders of both sides to achieve a path of sincere dialogue for a Korean peninsula that is free of nuclear weapons.
E perché la collaborazione possa proseguire portando frutti di bene.
I pray to the Lord that the hope for a future of peace and more fraternal friendship will not be disappointed, and that collaboration will continue to bear fruit for the beloved Korean people and for the whole world.
Con l'uccisione di un gruppo di fedeli, fra i quali due sacerdoti. Affidiamo a Dio.
Last week, the Christian community from Nigeria was again struck with the murder of a group of faithful, among them two priests.
Saluto con affetto i pellegrini oggi presenti.
We trust in the Lord. In His mercy, we put these brothers and sisters of this community for them to find peace.
Ma almeno saluto quelli provenienti da Braga, Portogallo, dall'India e dal Pakistan.
I greet the pilgrims present today with affection. There are too many to be able to name each group, but I greet those coming from Braga, Portugal, India and Pakistan, the pilgrims from Pavia, Crema and Vignale, the many boys and girls who have received or are about to receive confirmation, and the young people from Cuneo, Remedello, Arcore, Valle Alonna and Modica,
accompagnati dal vescovo.
A special thought goes to the confraternities of Assisi, coming with the bishop, to the young animators of the Giuseppini del Murialdo Fathers, and to participants of the National Conference of the Catechumens, promoted by the Italian Episcopal Conference.
Dopodomani, primo maggio, nel pomeriggio inizierò il mese mariano.
Dear brothers and sisters, the day after tomorrow, in the afternoon of May 1st, I will begin the Marian month with a pilgrimage to the shrine of Our Lady of Divine Love. There, we will pray the Rosary, praying in particular for peace in Syria and throughout the world. I invite you to join spiritually and to pray the Rosary for peace throughout the month of May. I wish you a good Sunday, and please do not forget to pray for me. Have a good lunch and see you soon. These are the words of Pope Francis. Thank you to all of you who join us today. We invite you to find a summary of the Pope's message on the website of Vatican News or the Facebook page, which will be available later in the day. Have a good day and God bless you. This is Deacon Cesar for Vatican Media. Laudetur Jesus Christus.